If you've got a spare minute, make sure you check out these legends. So today is another food festival. Like last time we had a food festival, we sold out, didn't we, before, like?
You did, yes.
We were open for an hour and a half, I think.
We sold out
completely. So we're getting ready for a busy day today. We don't normally, well, me and Lydia aren't normally in on Sundays because it's a nice easy day. So mum and dad will only be there by themselves with Lek and Kwan. But all barrels loose, we're all there today. And I'll show you why in a minute. So you can see just here. So starts all the way down there. Goes all the way up town. So many people. I don't know if you heard that, but Lydia is not a fan. But it goes all the way up. There's our restaurant there. Now you can see why the first time we were on, we sold out before, well, hour and a half. And we were open, what, for 4 hours? So we had to close and stay there for ages.
There's your dad just staring at a bench.
I don't know what dad's doing. Oh, he's filling up the thing. I mean, the camera's not doing it justice, but it's really fucking busy. Mum's about to try a churro from the food festival.
Bit soft, isn't it?
That's not a...
Oh, that got vanilla in there, that chocolate.
It tastes like Milo Bing. That's it?
I think maybe when it's colder, it's nicer. It's supposed to be a bit more fluffy, isn't it?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's too dense, I think.
Yeah.
That's my verdict.
Thank you. What, out of 10, ma?
Huh?
Out of 10. Is that the first time you've had a churro?
No, I had it before, not in here, in this country.
Yeah.
Back home we had them, but slightly different. Ours is a bit more fluffy on the top.
Right, okay.
Outside is crispier, inside a bit more fluffy.
Yeah.
A bit thicker.
Cool.
This one is quite dense.
So what do you give that out of 10?
About maybe... Me?
Yeah. Yeah, the wolf.
It's too salty, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I think about five.
Five, all right. That's better than I thought you were going to give.
Yeah. It's really sweet, though.
Yeah, it hurt my teeth.
Tooth, yeah.
It hurt my tooth as well.
Yeah.
You got these new umbrellas as well, which I think are pretty cool. They got a logo on and everything. Dad's been spending the morning putting them up. As you can see, getting busier and busier. So we've been open for about nearly an hour now, and it's quiet. Compared to last time, it is dead. So it might actually not be worth opening for food festivals. Well, I knew this would, I kind of thought this would happen. I didn't say no. I did say to everyone that I think we'd be quiet this time, because I think if we were so busy last time because we were brand new. Now everyone in town knows or has tried us, who would try us. There's no point in trying us for today. That makes complete sense to me. But it does mean that we won't be opening for food festivals. This just doesn't make sense. Like, there's literally no point in being here if we're only gonna take £200-300 for the day. That doesn't cover our daily costs. We need roughly about £600 a day. Yeah, £600 a day to stay afloat. That's not a tall order either. So if we don't open for that day, that number comes down to like £50 just for the standing electricity and stuff like that. But otherwise, stock, etc., it all mounts up, and it's cheaper not to open. Okay, so we did get busy. We're still as busy now. We've just had a lull. I've been out cooking for however long, probably about an hour and a half now. We've done all right. We've probably taken, what, in 2.5 hours, what we would take on a normal day, well, a weekday, for the full 6 hours we're open. We've got another hour and a half, and let's see what that brings. so I didn't fully fill you in. Oh, look, I've got a little bit of a cool thing going on there. Like I'm from the 50s. Anyway, where's my top knot? That's done. Yesterday, we were busy in the end. We did quite a lot. I'm not sure the final total, but it was the busiest day of the week we've had so far. We did most of that in the last 2 hours, but then I realised it was a football yesterday, wasn't it? So that's why we were so quiet. Right, Ian? So that's why we were so quiet until... massive shout out to Trunksy. He's just walking by over there, by the way. He doesn't watch the vlogs. You don't watch the vlogs, do you? Okay, yeah. All right. Do you want to be on one? He doesn't want to be on one. Are you out on Saturday?
Yeah.
All right, I'll probably see you there. Cool. See you later, mate. What are you talking about? Yeah, really busy yesterday. Absolutely killed it. Yeah, the women's football, that's what it was. That's why it was so quiet. Unfortunately, we didn't go through. I'm not interested in football in any way, shape or form, so that's why I didn't put two and two together, and I don't really listen to the radio or watch TV, so... But yeah, yesterday was worth opening, and we would do it again in a heartbeat. And next time, I think football isn't on, we'd easily do, I reckon, double what we took yesterday, which is a lot. Just clearing out the garage, and I found this box of stuff we were meant to review during lockdown and never got round to. It's all well out of date now. 2021... Shame. That's what happens when 2020, 21, they've changed their pots now. They looked better in black, but they probably cost too much in black. I don't know. But yeah, there we go. Just clearing out the garage here because we had an idea of making it into a studio. But the more I clear it out, the more I realise that it's not going to be big enough because the camera... lenses that we use need at least like 6 or 7 meters back in order to focus. 6 or 7, no, that's a lie. 3 to 4 meters in order to get us fully in frame. We're using our 50 millimeter lenses. So I'm not really sure what we're gonna do there. I wanna find a place we could rent, but I mean, nowhere around here is decent enough. They're all small like this. We need a high ceiling as well so we can get lights. I thought about using the warehouse, but that's a no-go. Lydia's made a mango cake. She's practicing her Chinese baking so that she can do like bits and bobs in the kitchen. Right, that didn't make sense. She doesn't want her face on camera. But when I say bits and bobs in the kitchen, I mean like so we can do pastries in the morning because we're essentially a cafe that sells is Far Eastern street food. So we're literally just a cafe if we were in East and South East, which I know I say this all the time, people go, why aren't you really good in the evenings? Well, because we're technically a cafe, and just because your cultural norms can't understand that this is daytime food for most other people in the world. No, I get it. You want to come out in the evening and enjoy the food, but at the same time, you know, we want to run a cafe, so that's what we're going to do. If I could get the staff, like actually reliable staff, I would open to the evenings, I'm not going to lie, because that is good money. But like, I need a whole nother team, and I could only get one person to apply for a job that I've had up for about 3 months now. That is just, like, no one wants to work in catering. Because one, we can't afford to pay as much as other types of businesses. And two, where we are, it's so seasonal that we only need them for 6 months of the year. So we have to employ them for an entire year, which is a massive outlay when we're not making that money for the entire year. It's not like when cities, it's not like when in city, it's not like if you're in a city where you've got all year round trade and there's slight peaks and troughs. Where we are, you go from taking, let's say, £1,000 to £3,000 a day to £100 to £300 for 6 months. And then that period in which you're taking all that money is only done within 5 good weeks. It's so difficult where we are. I think I might do a giveaway on this channel soon. I'm not sure what, but I'm going to be doing one definitely soon. Also, patrons, obviously, you guys are going to get an extra entry into the giveaway and an automatic one, I should say. Automatic one as well as whatever you do to fulfill the requirements for the giveaway on top of that. And I want to say massive shout out to my patrons. Thank you very much for signing up and supporting the channel, because you being there actually gets me and mum, believe it or not, one step closer to taking the content creation full time, or like we have to stop every summer to cook essentially, and it's just because of that we can never really fully grow properly. And it is a shame, but small donations, especially to this channel, to the main channel, helps no end. So massive thank you for that. And just imagine more mum, more of the time, that's what you're contributing to. So massive thank you. So you can see your names up here right now, or here. There'll be somewhere here. But that's it for today, guys. Thank you very much for watching. It's been a blast, and I hope you're enjoying the regular vlogs again. I'd like to do one a day, but it's literally impossible at the moment. So yeah, anyway, take care.